Hi everyone, welcome to another session of petroleum products. So we already discussed about the properties of petroleum products and properties of different petroleum products in detail. So next we'll go on to fractional distillation. So what is fractional distillation? Fractional distillation is a separating process. Of hydrocarbon components of the crude oil. So you know that from crude oil we are making petroleum products. So from crude oil, the hydrocarbon components of the crude oil are separating. This separating process is called as fractional distillation. And this is different from distillation only in the context that it separates a mixture into different fractions. In this setup, it consists of a long column fitted about the mixture, and the column consists of several condensers at different heights, and this is cold at top and hot at the bottom, and therefore high boiling point substances condense at the bottom and low boiling point substances at the top. Similar to distillation, fractional distillation is also based on the principle that different substances in a mixture have different boiling points and can be separated. So I will draw here a diagrammatic representation, and I will also send you the picture of how it looks like. So now for sake I will draw here. So like this a column is there. So like this a column is there, and here a tube is there. It is a refinery gas. After this process, and here also one tube is here, so this is for residue, and the column is like this. So here you have to give heat to a furnace. This is heat, and then the crude oil, the sample. So the crude oil, never mind about the diagram, it's like this. I will show you a good one. So the crude oil is passing through this tube, and heat is applied to this one, and it is going to this column. So here it is 40 degrees Celsius, then 110 degrees Celsius, then 180 degrees Celsius, then 260 degrees Celsius, and residue is of 340 degrees Celsius. So 40 degrees Celsius we will get petrol, and naphtha at 110 degree, and kerosene at 180, and 260 we will get diesel oil. So in this setup, a long tube is there and it fitted above the mixture. So the column consists of several condensers at different heights. Here, this is the condensers and different heights and different temperatures. So which is cold at top, and petrol is here. It's less temperature for petrol, so it will be at the top and hot at the bottom. So in a mixture, it means that crude oil is a mixture. So in mixture, we'll get different fractions of different boiling point. So let's see the procedure of distillation. Procedure of distillation. The components of crude oil differ in their size, weight, and boiling point. So the initial step is separation of these components. So in crude oil, there are crude oil is a mixture of many components. So it is of different size, weight, and boiling point. The first step is that you have to separate this according to the size, according to their weight, according to their boiling point. So as they have different boiling temperatures, fractional distillation is the best process. So that we are using fractional distillation for separating crude oil and to get the petroleum products. So first step, initially the crude oil is heated. Crude oil is heated to a temperature of 1112 degree Fahrenheit, that is 1112 Fahrenheit or 600 degree Celsius. So you have to heat this crude oil up to this temperature, and the mixture heats up and it forms vapors or gases. And second step is that the formed vapors, so after heating, what we'll get? We'll get vapors or gases. So after forming these vapors, the formed vapors are then moved down. This they will vapors moves down. Down to the bottom of the column. So this column is there, it will move to the bottom of the column. And third step is that the trays at the bottom have holes that allow the movement of vapor. So at the bottom of the column there are trays. So these trays helps the movement of the vapor. And fourth step is that the topmost segment of the column, topmost segment of the column is cold. So I explained the topmost is cold and bottom is hot. Therefore, vapor rises in the column and gets cooled. So the vapor, what will it will do? Vapor rises to the column and it tries to get cooled. So first you have to heat the crude oil at 1112 degree Fahrenheit or 600 degree Celsius, and it will form vapors or gases. So the vapors moves down, the formed vapors moves down to the bottom of that column. And there are so many trays to collect, there are trays to collect the movement of the vapor. So they allow the movement of the vapor, and the topmost part of the column is cooler than the bottom. So that what it will do, the vapors rises in the in the column and they try to get cooled. A substance in the vapor when reaches a height with the temperature equal to the boiling point of the substance. If the substance of the vapor, it reaches the temperature equal to the boiling point, equal to the boiling point, of the substance, it get condensed and liquid is formed. It get condensed and liquid is formed. This is then collected by the trays. So this liquid, this condensed liquid is collected by the trays. So that is our fractions or petroleum products. So there are two fractions are light fraction and heavy fraction. So after this we will get two fractions. One is light fraction and another is heavy fraction. So light fraction, for example, they are gasoline or petrol, then kerosene, then fuel oils. And heavy petrols we can heavy fraction we can say like lubricating oil, heavy gas oil. and other component is residues. So we will get after this fractional distillation, we will get light fraction, heavy fraction and also residues. So light fraction is gasoline, kerosene, fuel oil, etc. Heavy fraction is lubrication oil, heavy gas oil, etc. So this asphalt, cement, then waxes, etc. are residues. So these residues we can collect from the bottom of the column. So this is about the procedure of the fractional distillation. So fractional distillation is a separating process of hydrocarbon components of the crude oil, and this is different from that of distillation. How it is differing means it separates a mixture into different fractions, and in this setup it contains a long column fitted about the mixture, and the column consists of several condensers at different heights, and this is cold at the top and hot at the bottom. So therefore the boiling points of the substance condense at the bottom and low boiling point substances at the top, and this is the procedure. And according to the size, weight and boiling point of the crude oil we can separate it. So the crude oil is heated into vapors at the temperature of 600 degrees Celsius, and the vapors formed vapors moves down to the bottom, and the trays can allow the movement of the vapor, and topmost segment of the column is cold and bottom is hot, so that the vapor rises to the above portion of the column and it tries to get cool, and if it reaches the substance of the vapor reaches to the equal boiling point, then a condensed liquid is formed. So this liquid can be collected by the trays, and there are two fractions formed at that time, light fraction and heavy fraction. So light fraction examples are gasoline, kerosene, fuel oils, etc., and heavy fraction examples are lubricating oil, heavy gas oil, etc., and the asphalt, cement, waxes, etc. are the residue which we are collected from this fractional distillation, and we can collect it from the bottom of the portion of the column. So that is about fractional distillation. And next is a refining process. Refining process. So there are chemical or petroleum engineering process used to transform crude oil into a useful product such as LPG, gasoline or petrol, kerosene, jet fuel, diesel oil and fuel oils. So the fractions are further converted into mixtures having useful products. We collected fractional distillation products. So many fractions we got. So we have to convert these fractions into a usable products. So for that, so many methods are used, such as cracking, reforming, alkylation, polymerization, and isomerization. So the fractions are further converted into mixtures having useful products by these methods such as cracking, reforming, alkylation and polymerization, and also isomerization. These are further separated by fractionation and solvent extraction. So removal of impurities is done by number of methods such as dehydration, desalting, sulfur removal, and hydro treating. So we can remove the impurities of the fraction by dehydration, desalting, sulfur removal, and hydro treating. So while speaking about telling about the petrol component composition, I told you about the sulfur removal. sulfur is removed to prevent the octane improving effect. Sulfur is removing. Why? So why sulfur is removing in gasoline? It is to prevent its octane improving effect. So likewise, we can remove the impurities by using these methods. So these processes are developed in order to change the market demands of some products. And due to internal combustion engine, refineries are mainly used for the petrol production. The demand of the consumer can be satisfied by petrol formed by the distillation. So refineries are looking for techniques to enhance the quality of the produced petrol. Presently, there are two methods for refinery. Two methods are there. First one is breaking of large hydrocarbon molecules to smaller molecules. And second is reconstructing and reshaping of hydrocarbon molecules. So there are two methods used in refinery. First one is that breaking of large hydrocarbon molecules to smaller molecules and reconstructing and reshaping hydrocarbon molecules. So this is about refinery process. So I hope you understood about this fractional distillation and refinery process. And in next session we'll discuss about the products from crude oil in detail and their commercial uses. So let's wind up here. If you have any doubts, you can clear. Thank you.